you wanna put your name on it. Put your name on it. Come and put your name on it.
I'm falling hard. Yep, I'm falling for you, but there's nothing wrong with that. You don't wanna love you.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna be doing a how I curl my short hair. My hair is just in a messy ponytail right now, and I will probably just show you the basics, like the first couple of things, and then speed it up for you guys. But this is my natural hair. I did cut it recently. It has grown out because I'm Asian, so my hair grows pretty fast. You can see the roots have already started to grow out. But yeah, I'm now kind of, you know, a blonde. I've heard blondes have more funner. Funner's not a word, have more fun. But I don't have a difference. My life is still kind of boring. But yeah, this is my hair. It's kind of layered, and I'll show you how I curl it. So basically, the tool that I use is a Numi, and I love Numi. I don't know if you have heard of the site. I bet you guys have. They have a lot of like hair products, and there's usually a really good deal that you can find. I have the Octa Wand. Nobody needs no Octa Wand, I can tell you that right now. It comes with 8 wands. You don't need 8 wands, honey, because I only use like 3 of them. There's one that kind of looks like a dildo because it has like the balls, and I've never used that one, but I've seen people use it for beach waves. But yeah, I just use this one. I don't know what measurement it is. I'm so sorry. I think it's probably like a fourth of an inch or something like that. It's all the same length uniformly. It doesn't, you know, go from bigger to smaller. There is one that's like that, but I just use this one. And yeah, this is the tool. I really, really love it. I would say if you're not gonna use a mini, just get the Titan. I think it's what it's called. There's 3 sizes in that one. My sister has it. But yeah, I really love Numi. They have really good products. I have the straightener too. But yeah, this is the Octa Wand. I use this. I don't know the size. I am so sorry. But use one that's not like super skinny and not super large and not medium. It's like in between like the really small one and the medium one. I'm so sorry. I know this doesn't help you at all. If I figure it out, I'll put it down in the description of what size this is. Okay. So the thing is, I'll show you how it kind of works. Okay. You go. Psh. It's like a, what is it? Like Star Wars? Is that it? Like the little, what is it? I'm sorry, I'm really not into Star Wars. The blades or whatever, the little glowing saber thing. This is like, yeah. Anyhow, yeah. So basically, it has like these 4 hooks, and you just shove it in there. Oh my god, did I break it? Shove it in there, push it in, and then you twist it to lock it, and then yeah. Hold the power button, it's from blue, and then it starts counting, and then you can do it higher temperature. I do around, it goes all the way up to 450. I go 430 because I personally think, and I heard this before so I think it's correct, that it's actually healthier for your hair to do it at a higher temperature for less time. So it heats up really fast. I just put it, it's already at like 300. So it heats up really, really fast. That's what I love about this. And I'm gonna section off my hair. So I just go above my ears and straight across. Okay, and sorry, if I look over here, that's because I have my mirror, and that's what I'm gonna use mostly to look at, to know what I'm freaking doing without burning my hand off. I probably will still burn my hand, because I don't wear a glove, because I feel like I lose grip of I lose grip of the hair more. But yeah, so yeah, so this is the first layer, and the bottom layers are not as important, of course, because they're gonna be at the bottom. I will show you more in detail what I do, like, around the framing of my face and stuff like that. But here, I'll just quickly do the bottom layer and then fast forward the rest. So I just take tiny sections. I don't like taking big sections. I like taking small sections because I like to have it pretty curly. And then it's very easy to pop it behind, twist it till it's like at the root, and then rotate it. And I hold it on. I'm really weird. My favorite number is 3 and 7. So everything I have to do has to be in 3 and 7s. So I do it for 13 seconds, and that's usually good. I think it's already been 13 seconds. And I let it go into my hand and just let it cool off a little bit. And then let it go. It looks very short right now, I know, but it will look better when they all do fall. You know, curls do fall eventually. So take another tiny section. And what I do when I curl my hair is that I don't do them all in the same way. For example, for that one, I did it backwards. But for this one, I'm gonna do it going inwards. So instead of putting the barrel behind, I'm gonna put the barrel in front and curl inwards, like so. Another, you know, 13 seconds or whatever seconds you want, 10, 15. If you have thicker hair, I would say definitely hold it on longer, but I have like medium hair. I don't have fine or thick hair. It's kind of in the middle. So yeah, around 13 seconds. I'm not really counting because I'm talking. Let it go in your hand. I hold it in my hand for only about like 5 to 7 seconds. Let it go. Do the next one. Same process. And this one, of course, like I said, I'm alternating directions. What the heck is wrong with this? Yeah. I'm alternating directions, so I'm gonna go outwards again instead of in. That one was a thinner piece, so I just held it on a little bit shorter. But now I'm going to fast forward everything until I get to the next layer, do a little example again, fast forward, and then focus more on the top layer and how I do that. Is the first side done, and I'm not gonna record the second side. I'm just gonna do it, and so I don't waste the all the battery or storage or whatever, and then I'll be back. So I got the first layer done, and I'm going to section off the next layer to do. So usually I just go about an inch above my last layer. So the last one was at my ears, so I'm gonna go probably like the middle of my forehead and just go again straight across and section it off. I'm gonna put some tunes on for you. Well, not for you, because probably I'll get copyrighted. So for me. So again, I'm gonna do the exact same thing. Take small little sections, first going from the back forward, and then alternating from outward curls to inward curls. By the way, this is Quinn XCII or something. I just say Quincy. But this is my favorite song from him. It's Another Day in Paradise. If you have not heard of him or listened to any of his music, I highly recommend it. It's very good. if you can tell, I've been on all the strands that are like close to my face frame. But instead of, I know that a lot of people say go outwards because it frames your face, but for like tight curls like these, I think it looks better if they go inwards. I don't know why, I just think it gives it that like retro curl, and it also looks more natural to me, because a lot of times like hair, like all the strands do not go perfectly outwards. A lot of them go inwards. So that's why also I alternate them, but I don't know. I just like the look of curls going inwards, framing your face. So yeah, most of the curls surrounding my hairline are going to be inwards, not outwards. Again, I'm going to turn off the camera and do the other side real quickly so you guys don't have to see that and have to watch basically the same thing over and over again. So yeah,
this part, actually this is not the top layer, this is the second to last top layer. So for me, I have a little widow's peak, as you can see, so it gives me like a cute little heart shape, you know, head. But anywho, so it kind of goes like this, and what I do is I do where I section it off, where my little, like, it goes to a point right here. So, yeah, I just go like that, and then pull it back. And then that's going to be my last layer. This is, like, I guess you would consider the crown area that people, you know, when teasing was, like, a huge thing, people would tease the crown area, and then this would be the area. But, you know, yeah, just leave this section alone.
Actually, this is, like, a little bit too much hair, honestly. So, let me resection it up. That's better. So I went a little bit too far up. So when I resectioned it, I went even deeper far back to pull back more hair. And yeah, I'm gonna curl this real quickly and then I come back. I look like a plant. A cute one. So it looks kind of bad right now because yeah, obviously the top layer isn't finished and they're really tight right now, but once, you know, the top layer is done and you brush them out with your fingers, it looks so much better than this, because I look kind of like a little poodle right now. But yeah, I'm gonna show you in detail, talk you through how I finish off curling my hair and how I do the top layer specifically. So for this is actually, like, it doesn't seem like it, but it actually kind of is a lot of hair. So I make sure I have the part that I want. I don't do it too much to one side, because then with curls, if you have too much hair on one side, since curls give it a volume, they kind of like stack up on top of each other, it would be like super high on this side, and then, like, you know, that's not good. So basically, yeah, I part it where I want it to be, and then I start again from the back and then go forward. And then I honestly do personally section it off again, but for this I don't put it in a ponytail, I just, you know, flip it to the other side, because you don't really need to put it in a ponytail, honestly, because you'll go through this pretty fast. So I do basically the exact same thing. I alternate inwards and outwards, but I do it kind of differently on how I hold and the curl and the iron. So instead, before I was doing like this, now how I keep volume at the root is I put the burl right onto the root and go like this. So it's like perpendicular to the hair and right at the root, instead of going like this. That adds vertical volume at the root. Okay, that's actually kind of a thick piece, so hold on. Okay, so do that again and go outwards. Pull it out and hold it and just let it go. Do the same thing to the next piece, but again, alternate it. So instead, go inwards, do it right at the root, and wrap your hair around it. Hold it. And let it go. As you can see, like, it's already creating volume right at the root, which is what I personally like. And if that's what you like, yeah, do the exact same thing that I'm doing by doing it like this and perpendicular and putting the iron right at the root and then wrapping the hair around. Again, like I said, for these pieces up at the front, I'm going to curl them towards my face. So actually for this one, I'm gonna curl outwards. Hold on. Cause it's not the one straight near my frame of my face on my hairline. So yeah, so for the strand right near my hairline, I'm gonna go inwards, and there you go. Do this again, but I'm gonna do it in one, two more sections. Again, inwards on the last frontal piece. Oh my god, my legs are dying. That's one side done, and I'm going to quickly finish this side and just fast forward it again so you guys don't have to watch all of it, because it's basically the exact same thing that I did over here on this side. So yeah, perpendicular, put it right at the root, alternate with the front pieces going inwards. I'm not even gonna fast forward, I'm just gonna do it off camera and then show you the final result. Sorry, my knees are killing me, so yeah. Okay, so I have two more strands left. So I basically did the same thing that I did on this side. I cut it in half and started from back to front. And these are the last two strands. So this one's going to go, this one's gonna go outwards. And this one is gonna go inwards. So obviously they're very tight right now, so what I do is I shake them out with my fingers. You don't want to use like a brush because that's gonna just completely destroy the curls. So just gently, what I do is I just go like this and I just try to gently toss them around and loosen them a little bit. give them a good little shake. So another thing I do is like you're warming your hands, but like put the curls in between them and rub a little bit. This will definitely make the curls separate a little bit more and gain more volume to them. Let me change my top real quickly so you know you get the whole vibe. This is the final result. I absolutely love them. I think they look very, like, not natural, really. I mean, kind of natural because they go right from the root and they're in alternating directions. So, I don't know. I just really like the look of them. I think they obviously give me a lot of volume, which I love. And I just think they're so cute. And they really show off, you know, my blonde hair now because it has, like, the blonde, so you can see the low lights and the highlights. But yeah, so I don't know, I just think I look really cute, like a little Asian Shirley Temple type of person thing. So yeah, it takes obviously a bit of time, and it does use heat, so it's your choice if you rather. I know you can do probably these with like the those things, the bendy sticks or straws or something like that. But I personally don't wanna. I like these because they're faster than that, because you have to wait overnight for your hair to dry and you don't have to like do it over the straw and then I don't know. So this is how I do it with a curling wand, and I think the results are really good. So yeah, that's basically how I get my curls, like this. And I will also do a continuation. If this video is too long, I'm just going to do a separate video on like hairstyles that you can do with like curly short hair. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.